So we're working on the Euthyphro Dilemma. The Euthyphro Dilemma was posed by Socrates to another person in the dialogue named Euthyphro. Now you know where they came up with the name of the dialogue. And he is posing, he's trying to answer a particular question with the Euthyphro Dilemma. So what question is Socrates trying to answer? Now just, you know, kind of keep in mind here, he's doing something really different from any of the philosophers that we looked at so far this semester. Remember the previous philosophers, right? We had Hume and Sumner trying to answer the question, how are moral beliefs justified? We have Glaucon and Hobbes trying to answer the question, whose interests are most important? We have Aristotle and Epicurus trying to answer the question, what has moral worth? That was the first reading of Aristotle. The second reading of Aristotle is trying to answer the question, how does one acquire what has moral worth? And then we have Locke trying to answer the question, well, what are your rights? And after that, we had Mill, who actually took on two questions. What has more worth? How does one acquire it? And then the last one we just covered was Kant, trying to answer the question, what is your duty? Now, each of these philosophers were offering a moral theory. They're trying to answer the question, how should you live your life, by answering the second question. And each of these directly informed the moral theory. Now, Socrates is doing something different. He's not necessarily trying to answer, he's not necessarily trying to answer the question, how should you live your life? At least not directly with this question. And even indirectly, still becomes a little bit muddled. So what's he trying to do? Well, with this Euthyphro Dilemma, he's trying to answer the question, what is the relationship between religion and morality? He's trying to figure out, he's just not going to deny that there are religions. Right. Obviously, there are religions. Of course, there are religions. But the question is, well, okay, supposing that there Socrates' case was the Greek gods. Suppose there are those Greek gods. Suppose those religions are there, and they're, you know, it's just perfectly fine, right? There's nothing wrong with thinking that there's Apollo I'm just blanking the names. There's Apollo and Zeus and Hera. And Ares, there's no problem saying that there are these gods. Okay. If there are these gods, then what's the relationship between religion and morality? Now, Socrates' answer is, there isn't one.